Hey everyone, in case you're unaware, AMD AM5 motherboards powered by the newly released mid-range B650E and B650 chipsets are now available for purchase on the market. For today's video, we'll be taking a look at an entry-level B650 motherboard, the Gigabyte B650M DS3H. Sporting support for the latest Ryzen 7000 series of processors, let's have a look at this board to see if it's any good. To recap, AMD launched its AM5 platform and the Ryzen 7000 series of processors alongside the range-topping X670E and X670 chipsets on 27 September 2022, and one thing that stood out was the value proposition or lack of it, seeing as X670E and X670 boards were really pricey, making lower-end Zen 4 parts such as the Ryzen 5 7600X questionable in terms of their price-to-performance ratio in a completed build with a X670 series motherboard. The launch of the B650E and B650 therefore strives to create more value, hopefully, for potential Ryzen 7000 series consumers in the mid to low end. To achieve these lower price points, AMD's paired away some features from the X670 family of chipsets so as to create the B650E and B650 as you can see on the screen. Now the B650M DS3H that we have here today, as its name implies, sports the entry-level AMD B650 chipset and sits within the ultra-durable series of budget-oriented motherboard offerings, where it places below the Gaming X and Aorus series of product offerings by Gigabyte. As such, the B650M DS3H comes in a black and orange colorway that has come to be associated with the ultra-durable series of boards. Moving over to the rear of the box, we get the usual overview of specs for this board, nothing really fancy to call out here. We'll cover the board specs in depth in the next few minutes of this video. On a side note, if you're new to the ALKtech channel, do consider subscribing so as to keep up to date with the latest product releases in the PC hardware world. Let's set aside the board for the moment to see what accessories Gigabyte has included with the board. Being an offering from the entry-level ultra-durable series of products, the B650M DS3H comes with the bare minimum in terms of accessories. We get two SATA 3 cables, and this is accompanied by an I/O shield, two packs of M.2 drive screws, and this is rounded off by a quick start leaflet. With that, onto the board itself. Here we have it, the B650M DS3H. We see that Gigabyte has gone for a black and grey colour scheme with these abstract, industrial-looking motifs on the PCB and heatsinks. The board does not come with an integrated I/O shield design and has black-coloured heatsinks all around. Do note that this board does not come with any built-in RGB LEDs of any sort, though it does come with RGB headers for you folks out there intending to spice up your PC build with RGB bling. I'll talk about the placement of these headers later in this video. The VRM heatsinks for this board are surprisingly pretty decently sized for an entry-level motherboard, and Gigabyte has included 6+2+1 power stages rated for up to 60 amps. Unlike the X670E, the B650 has a single chipset design, and the said chipset sits beneath this nondescript-looking passive heatsink right here. For M.2 drive cooling, Gigabyte's included a shared heatsink for the two M.2 slots that this board comes with. For memory support, the B650M DS3H comes with 4 DDR5 slots with support for up to 128GB of RAM and the DDR5 6400+ standard when overclocked, with plastic slots of a single tab design. It also features AMD's Expo technology, which are basically built-in overclocking profiles for DDR5 memory, similar to what XMP stands for in Intel's world. Near the RAM slots is a USB 3.2 Gen 2 Type-C front panel header, and further down, a USB 3.2 Gen 1 front panel header positioned in a right-angle configuration so as to aid with cable management. The said header provides support for two USB 3.2 Gen 1 Type-A ports. While still on the topic of USB connectivity, the bottom edge of the board houses two USB 2.0 front panel headers, with each header providing support for two USB 2.0 Type-A ports. Some other features to highlight, we get a multi-key button right here that can be configured within the BIOS to perform different functions, such as to serve as a reset switch or to control the RGB lighting effects of supported peripherals that are connected to the board. We also get a serial port header right here, which could come in handy for situations that call for the use of legacy PC hardware. In terms of expansion slots, this board comes with a reinforced PCIe 4.0x16 slot that sports the PCIe Easy Latch feature, which is essentially an oversized graphics card retention tab that helps with graphics card removal. We also do get a PCIe 3.0x1 slot right here. In the storage department, Gigabyte has included 4 SATA 3 ports, with all ports in a right-angled configuration so as to aid with cable management. For M.2 slots, it comes with 2 PCIe 4.0x4 M.2 slots. Both of these slots support NVMe M.2 SSDs only. M.2 SATA SSDs are not supported. For audio, Gigabyte has included an entry-level Realtek ALC897 audio codec, while wired internet connectivity is courtesy of a Realtek part as well, the RTL8125BG chip, which provides support for 2.5 gigabit Ethernet. In the cooling and RGB departments, the board comes with 4 fan headers, which are located in these regions of the board. Also included is a single addressable RGB header and a 12-volt standard RGB header located right here. Moving over to the rear I/O, the B650M DS3H goes for a traditional I/O layout that calls for the use of an I/O shield, and it comes with 4 USB 2.0 Type-A ports, a PS2 mouse and keyboard combo port, 2 DisplayPort 1.4 connectors that support the 4K resolution at 144Hz, a HDMI 2.1 port that supports the 4K resolution at 60Hz, a USB 3.2 Gen 2 Type-A port that also supports the Q-Flash Plus feature, a USB 3.2 Gen 2 Type-C port, a Q-Flash Plus button that allows users to update the board's BIOS without needing to install a CPU, RAM, or graphics card, a 2.5 Gigabit Ethernet port, 2 USB 3.2 Gen 1 Type-A ports, as well as your usual audio jack connectors. With that, the Gigabyte B650M DS3H shapes up to be an entry-level AMD B650 motherboard that, in my opinion, would be well-suited for low to mid-range PCs powered by the lower tiers of AMD's Ryzen 7000 series of processors, such as the 7600X, or even CPU and APU offerings from perhaps the Zen 4 Ryzen 3 series of offerings that I'm guessing will be announced and launched in due course. Bearing in mind that this is a budget-oriented board after all, Gigabyte still managed to squeeze in features such as 2.5 gigabit Ethernet, a good variety of USB 3.2 ports, and heat sinks all around. One issue that needs to be addressed, however, is its price. As of early November 2022, the B650M DS3H is available in Singapore for a price of around SGD 325 through offline and online retailers, while for you international folks, this board can be had for around $160 from e-commerce sites such as Newegg. It would appear that gone are the days where we could get really cheap budget motherboard offerings from AMD, which is indicative of the value problem that the AMD AM5 platform is facing as a whole across all of its board partners. My take is that AMD will have to lower its AM5 processor and board prices so as to be of any relevance at the low to mid-range, especially in the face of stiff competition from Intel's 13th generation Raptor Lake offerings, which serve up better performance and value at this point in time. With that, thanks so much for watching, hit the like button and get subscribed if you've enjoyed this video, and I'll catch you guys around the next time.